Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Hooked in Loops. If you have still not subscribed to my channel, then please hit the subscribe button, and for getting updates of new videos, then please click the bell icon. Today I will show you how easily I make this crochet coffee mug cozy. And in this tutorial, I will show you how to do the crochet puff V stitch. This project I am using a hook of size 3mm and an acrylic yarn of same size. I am using this coffee mug as a reference. Okay, you will be making your chains according to the size of your coffee mug. At first I will make a slip knot, okay, and then I will insert the hook in this slip knot. I will be doing chain 42. The chains should be multiple of 3, and this chain 42 encircles my coffee mug very easily. So your number of chains will depend on the circumference of your coffee mug. Just remember, the number of chains should be multiple of 3. Our 42 chains are done. Now we will be closing the circle. Okay, just make sure that your chains is not folded. Okay, simply do a slip stitch in the first chain to close the circle. We are doing a slip stitch. Okay, it's done. Then secure the slip stitch with a chain 1. Okay, so the first foundation chain circle is done. Then in each of the chain we are going to do one single crochet. So we begin with a single crochet in the first chain itself. Then in the remaining 41 chains we are going to do one single crochet each. So in total there are 42 single crochets in this round. We will complete this round quickly and then come back to you. We will do our last single crochet now. And then we will complete this round with a slip stitch in the first single crochet of this round. Okay. The slip stitch is done. And then we will just do a chain 1. I will slowly show you how to do the beginning puff stitch. Pull the hook, yarn over, insert your hook in the first single crochet stitch of the previous round. Pull the yarn through it. Okay. Then again we will yarn over. Again we will insert our hook in the same stitch and pull the yarn through it. We will do the same thing again. We will yarn over and then we will insert our hook in the same stitch and pull the yarn through it. We did this step for 3 times, but if you wish you can do it for 5 times for a bigger puff. Now in the hook there will be 7 loops. Okay, after you are confirmed that there are 7 loops, just yarn over and pull the yarn through all the 7 loops. Okay, and your first puff stitch is done. To secure the puff stitch we will do a chain 1. For the chain 1 gap of the V stitch we did another chain 1, and then in the same stitch we will do another puff stitch in the same manner. Okay, that is yarn over, insert your hook in the same stitch, pull the yarn through it and repeat it for 3 times. okay, until there are 7 loops in your hook. Okay, so now there are 7 loops in your hook. Just pull the yarn through all the 7 loops and secure it with a chain 1, and your second puff stitch is also done. Then we will yarn over, skip 2 stitches, and in the following stitch we will do another puff stitch. Okay, that is yarn over, insert your hook in the stitch, pull the yarn through it, repeat it 3 times until there are 7 loops in your hook. Okay, pull the yarn through all the 7 loops and then do a chain 1 to secure it, and another chain 1 for the chain 1 space of the V stitch, and in the same stitch we will do another puff stitch. Okay. Do a chain 1 to secure it, and our puff V stitch is done. I will show you once again how to do the puff V stitch. We will yarn over, skip the next 2 stitches, insert your hook in the following stitch, pull the yarn through it, again yarn over, insert your hook in the same stitch, pull the yarn through it, yarn over, insert your hook in the same stitch, pull the yarn through it, and then pull the yarn through all the 7 loops, and then do a chain 1 to secure it, chain 1 for the chain 1 space of the V stitch, and then again in the same stitch we will do another puff stitch. Okay. Do a chain 1, and then our third puff V stitch is done. We will repeat it throughout this round till we reach the end. Okay. We are doing the last set of puff V stitch. Okay. Chain 1 to secure the puff stitch, another chain 1 for the chain 1 space of the V stitch. Then in the same stitch we will do another puff stitch. Okay. Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops to form the puff. Okay. Then do a chain 1 to secure it, and we came to the end of this round. Simply complete this round with a slip stitch in the first puff stitch at the top. Okay. Insert your hook in that stitch, pull the yarn through it. Okay. And then pull the yarn through that loop in your hook. Okay, to do the slip stitch. Then chain 1 to secure it, but do not cut the yarn. We will do a color change now. Okay. We will use another yarn of contrasting color, make a slip knot, and insert the hook in it. Okay. We will insert our hook in the first V stitch space. Okay. And then do a slip stitch there. Okay. To secure the slip stitch, we will do a chain 1. And then we will pull the hook, yarn over, insert a hook in the same space, pull the yarn through it, and do a puff V stitch as earlier. Okay, the first puff done, there are 7 loops in your hook. We will pull the yarn through all the 7 loops, do a chain 1 to secure it, another chain 1 for the space. Then we will do another puff stitch in the same V stitch space. I hope you know how to do the puff stitch by now. Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops and do a chain 1 to secure it. Then yarn over. Okay. In the next V stitch space, we will do another puff V stitch. I will show you slowly how to do the puff stitch again in the following puff V stitch. Okay. For the next puff V stitch, we will yarn over, Insert our hook in the next V-stitch space, pull the yarn through it, yarn over again, insert your hook in the same space, pull the yarn through it, yarn over again, insert your hook in the same space and pull the yarn through it, okay? Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops in your hook. Make sure that there are 7 loops. Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops and do a chain 1 to secure it. Chain 1 for a space, then yarn over and in the same space insert your hook, pull the yarn through it, yarn over again, insert your hook in the same space and pull the yarn through it, and yarn over again and insert your hook in the same space for the last time and pull the yarn through it. Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops in your hook and do a chain 1 to secure your puff stitch. So your puff V-stitch is done. I hope you understood it. Okay. We will repeat it throughout this round, okay, till we reach the end. We will now do our last puff V stitch. I think it's very easy. This entire mug cozy is too easy and too fast. You can easily make this for anyone, and any beginner can make this as a gift for loved ones. We will secure this puff stitch with a chain 1 and complete this round with a slip stitch in the first puff stitch of this round. Pull the yarn through it and then through that loop. Slip stitch done and secure it with a chain 1, but do not cut it. Okay? Now we will use the yarn of the first round, okay? So insert your hook in the first V stitch space, insert your hook in that pink colored loop, okay, of that first round, pull it through that space and then do a chain 1, okay? So it's done, and pull the hook, yarn over, insert your hook in the same space and do a beginning puff as earlier shown. Okay, pull the yarn through all the 7 loops, secure it with a chain 1 and then another chain 1 for the space, and then in the same space we will do another puff stitch. Okay, pull the yarn through all the 7 loops and secure it with a chain 1. Okay, so your first puff V stitch is done. Then we are going to do another puff V stitch in the following V stitch space in the same manner. We will repeat it. Okay. We will repeat it throughout the round and at the end just complete it with a slip stitch in the first puff stitch of this round. We have done nearly 5 rounds of puff V stitches. It appears to be braided, as you can see, and it gives a very good finishing. Okay. We will begin the next round. Insert your hook in the first V stitch space, then insert your hook in that loop of the previous round, pull that loop through that space and do a chain 1. Then begin by doing the first beginning puff stitch. Okay, I have shown these many times how to do this. Pull the yarn through all the 7 loops, then do a chain 1 to secure it, and then another chain 1 for the space, and in the same V stitch space we are doing another puff stitch, okay, to form the puff V stitch. So the first puff V stitch is complete. We will do another puff V stitch in the following V stitch space. We will repeat this throughout this round till we reach the end. We will do the last puff V stitch of this round. We will now complete this round with a slip stitch in the first puff stitch of this round. Okay, so the slip stitch is done. We will secure it with a chain one. Okay, and our this round is also complete. We will simply cut the yarn. Now do a border of half double crochet, insert your hook in that V stitch space and pull that loop through that space as I'm showing you. Okay, and then just do a chain one and one more chain. Okay, so in total two chains. This is the first half double crochet of this round. Okay, we will yarn over and do another half double crochet in this space. Yarn over and do one half double crochet in this space just after the puff V stitch, and then again in the next same two space of that V stitch space we are going to do two half double crochet, then in the following space one half double crochet, and then two half double crochet in the next space. Okay, again in the following space one half double crochet. So in the V stitch spaces we are doing two half double crochets, and in the space just after the V stitch we are going to do one half double crochet. Okay, so we will repeat it throughout this round. Okay, so we have reached the end of this round. In the last V stitch space we are doing two half double crochets. Okay, and just after the V stitch we are doing one half double crochet. Okay, so we completed our border. We will just complete it with a slip stitch in the second chain of the starting chain two of this round, followed by a chain one, and we will cut the yarn and pull it like this. Okay, so our puff V stitch coffee mug cozy is ready. We will just weave in the loose ends and get it ready now. So our mug cozy is now completely ready. I hope you liked this tutorial. If you liked this tutorial, then please hit the like button, comment in the comment section for any queries, and I will always answer your queries. And please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a great day.